Say when.
All right, Vicky, what are you doing today?
I am doing something that I have found that I really like doing. I am painting pottery. And sometimes I paint an actual cup or a saucer or a teapot, or I paint a tile, and that's really creative. But what I'm doing this week is I'm painting a pot. But you know what I'm really doing? I'm taking the time to take care of myself. And we hear about how we need to take care of ourselves, i.e. we need to drink water, we need to take vitamins and supplements, we need to eat right. But people think, oh, that's a lot of work, or that's a lot of effort to do that. But all it is simply taking a drink of water. And if you take lots of those, that's how you take care of yourself.
So it's really lots of little stuff, a lot more than any one big thing.
Yes, it is.
How long have we been coming here?
I think we've been coming here, this is about probably 7 weeks.
Every Tuesday?
Every Tuesday we come here. Nate and I come here, and we sit and we talk, and we enjoy the company of the proprietor. George is his name. He's a lot of fun. He'll be back shortly. But we come here and we just paint, and it's just very easy. There's nobody to tell you it's good, bad, or indifferent. You just paint, and you just express yourself in painting it. That's all it is, and it's just to be creative and have some fun.
Hey, Vicky, will you show me the tile you painted last week?
I will.
I'm going to go ahead and pause this, and we'll be right back.
All right. This is the tile that I painted, and it's taken me 3 weeks because I designed it myself. It was a blank tile, just like that, and I painted this. I designed it. Now,
it
George...
looks, Vicky, like you have a unicorn with wings playing a drum in front of a rainbow walking around a meadow. What is the what do the words say in the cloud there?
The words say, march on to the drum you beat.
And why is that significant to you? Tell me about the whole thing.
Okay. Well, to start with, George came to us one day because we've talked to him and we've become friends with him. And he asked Nate and I to be part of his tile project because some of his regular customers are going, they painted tiles, and he's going to tile his entire area by his sinks. And that way, then when the kids come in, they can see them and get something inspirational at the same time. So I wanted to pick something that kids love, but I wanted something that will teach kids to do what they want to do. Don't do what their parents, you know, want them to do for life.
Hence your own drum, because it's just about right. Coming in and having a good time.
Having a good time. Do your own thing.
Okay, so show me again and show
okay.
The thing.
Why so did you pick what a... I picked a unicorn. Mm-hmm. Okay, because kids love unicorns.
Okay.
They're
whimsical. How did you know that? Why did you paint the unicorn pink?
Because what I did is the day that I after I was done tracing it, there were several little girls in here, mm-hmm. and I went over and I talked to each one of them and asked them
what color is a unicorn. Of course you did.
Yes, and they all told me that it was a consensus. They all picked pink.
All right.
Then they said that his mane was white with golden layers.
Okay.
Now, then I talked to him about a Pegasus, because a Pegasus and a unicorn usually aren't the same animal, but in this case, mine
is. But when you're five, who cares?
That's right.
Or when you're Vicky, who cares?
That's right.
Okay.
And so I made his wings, and they all told me that his wings were sparkly blue.
Well, so then they must be sparkly blue.
I did sparkly blue.
Okay.
Now, my coat and my uniform is a little dark for me. So you can't quite see it.
It's purple,
it's
though.
Good. It's purple because that's a really good color. Okay? So then he had to have a drum beating it himself. Of course, the unicorn tail
and
is always
a rainbow.
Is a rainbow because it's, you know, attached to his, you know,
and
his
kids
body.
Don't care that his mane is gold, his wings are blue, and his tail is rainbow. That's just what walking bipedal unicorns with Pegasus wings look like.
That's what my unicorn looks like. And my unicorn identifies with every child that was in here.
Okay. That sounds like you got a winner.
So that's what I did.
May I tell you about mine?
I do.
All right. So this is mine.
Hi, Nate.
Hi, Vicky.
Tell me about yours.
All right. As part of the George's Tile Project, I did this. Is that good? Okay. And it says, when you can't control, create.
Move your fingers out of the way.
My fingers in the way. Okay. And that is the hand of God, as painted originally by Michelangelo in the Sistine Chapel. Except instead of creating Adam, he is painting a little bisque dog. Because basically, if We have free will. God, if God exists, has chosen not to control us, so we have the complete freedom to do whatever we want. And so the general philosophy behind this is, if you are in a spot where things are outside your control, you can at least make something. You can make the situation what you want to. You can do something with it. You can have some fun with it, or just paint something and find the pleasure in that, in the part that you can control or choose to control or can get involved in. So that was the little bit of mine, of have some fun.
I think that's great. Thank you very much for sharing that, Nate.
That's that. Oh, we should do a real quick logo shot at the end. Would you pause? I'll delete that. We're just... There we go. Art's on fire. Highlands Ranch. One of our new favorite places.